my early life, I grew up in New Jersey. My father was born in Ghana, West Africa. My mother was from New Orleans, Louisiana. And I grew up in the suburbs in South Orange, New Jersey. I always knew I wanted to be an artist. I was the youngest in my family, so my parents really indulged me. Because I was the youngest, my sisters and brother had already ran the gamut. By the time I came around, I was allowed to be what I was. And so from a very young age, I was already getting that special attention towards the arts. When I got to Howard, there was a creativity in the School of Fine Arts and outside that was all around us that made me feel like I could bloom here, I could grow, and that people understood me. Nobody looked at my final projects perplexed, like, what is this? I was allowed to be myself. I met my husband at Howard. He is Howard through and through. His parents went to Howard and met at Howard. His creative influence as a musician and somebody with a fine ear for music has infused my work. One thing that's really interesting about Howard and all of the HBCUs, the professors are some of the best Black artists in the world. The Lois Jones, Elizabeth Catlett, Jacob Lawrence taught, John Biggers taught, like some of the most famous, strongest, powerful artists spent years teaching because we as Black artists didn't necessarily get the financial benefit that other artists had, so they couldn't just step off and only do art. So we were being taught by the best professionally and aesthetically. Our professors, a lot of them were members of AfriCobra because the dean of the School of Fine Arts, Jeff Donaldson, was one of the founding members of AfriCobra. And they call themselves the African Coalition of Bad and Relevant Artists. And so those are my professors. I appreciate Al Smith taking time to actually look at me, look at what I'm wearing. Look at the colors of African fabric. Look at the colors of our skin and really study them. And that was the moment that it all came together. Al Smith telling me, use your fabric. The fabric scraps that I used were already my own, plus fabric from my mother and grandmother who also sewed clothing. I was trying to put a face to an unknown, which is a lot of what I do in my work now. Always wonder, what about those people who came before? What did they look like? What were they like? And sometimes I think about, who were my ancestors who were actually enslaved? Well, who was the first? And what was their name? And what was their life like? And what happened to them that I'm now benefiting from, even my very existence? It's like a exploration of self as a Black American, wanting to know the ancestors who were stolen away from us. Then I'm sketching, like somebody who draws. Then I'm cutting, like somebody who sews. And then I'm putting it together, like somebody who paints or collages. I use a lot of sheer layers, which is what a painter does. You paint in layers. And then I sew it up again, like somebody who quilts. So I'm combining all of these things that are in our ancestry. I am so proud to receive a Distinguished Alumni Award for Postgraduate Achievement. It means so much for me as a student of the new Chadwick Boseman School of Fine Arts, with Dean Rashad at the head of the School of Fine Arts. It feels amazing to be able to, in theory or in actuality, let my professors know that I did good, I did what they said, and that I'm gonna pass that torch on to the next one. It means a lot.